You might ask yourself, what is insurance? Well, by definition, it's a contractual agreement by two parties that protects against loss of one party. Well, basically, it is just you getting your butt covered just in case ac an accident happens with your property. Come on, we've all seen the various commercials.
Hello?
Hello.
This is Dylan from State Farm. How can I help you?
I was calling to inquire about your policy.
Well, saying that this is a pretty clean-cut insurance company, you know, your policy is going to stay the same every month unless you get into an accident.
Oh, okay. Well, what is your premium? How much is that?
The premium? Premium is $25 a month, like I said before, unless you get in an accident or something like that.
Okay. Is there any risk?
What's the risk? Well, saying it's insurance, it's pretty risky, I guess.
That sounds awesome. Oh, that's a great deal. Oh my
Who are you
gosh.
talking to, Christina?
It's Dylan from State Farm.
Who's this Dylan from State Farm? Can I talk to him?
Sure.
Hello, Dylan from State Farm. Yeah. What are you wearing?
Well, it's Casual Friday, so I'm wearing a French hat and khakis.
Does that commercial ring a bell? Well, if it doesn't, there are many terms within it that need to be described so you can better understand how it applies to your insurance. At the beginning, a so-called policy was being talked about, which simply means a written contract of insurance. That was what Dylan was offering to Christina in order to buy for insurance. Further into the video, Christina asked for the premium, which is simply the dollar amount to be paid each month to the insurance company. This can depend on what kind of insurance you're getting, and also if you get into an accident or something that really bothers the insurance that you have. Furthermore, she asked for the risk, and the risk can differ greatly depending on what type of insurance you have. Something can be very unique and have a great risk that you won't even have to have that insurance, or another thing can be a bit less risky, like automobile insurance, because you know it'll be covered. That's exactly the point. Depending on what insurance you have, your risk and premium may be higher than others. So what insurance do you need? Well, depending on what you need to be taken out, your insurance may differ. The most common type of insurance are property, casualty, life insurance, and health and disability insurance. We've all seen those various commercials that offer health and or home insurance.
Last Thanksgiving, about 2 million people tried to deep fat fry their turkey. 15 succeeded in setting their houses on fire. At Christmas, there was a lot of driving over the river and through the woods, and a little bit of skidding on the ice and taking out grandma's garage door. So while you're celebrating, Allstate will be standing by.
It has been seen that many American families do have property insurance, but they do not know how it obtains to their family and how it affects their insurance, and even what does it even protect. In most cases, it protects from fire. Fire is usually resulting from fire or a lightning strike or removal from a premises, and this is what fire insurance is. In basic fire insurance, there are endorsements which basically help you find out and prove that the fire caused the loss of your property, and that helps you provide for the indemnification or paying back to your original amount of your property. Finally, there's coinsurance, which is basically a clause that requires the insulted to maintain coverage equal to a certain percentage, or as it basically is explained, that as your property value increases, then the coverage amount has to be increased as well because it is more valuable to the insurance company and you want it to be covered. Other than home insurance, we see many other types of insurances that are very valuable to have. For instance, many of our families have liability insurance, which is a type of casualty insurance that indemnifies against personal injury or property damage claims for which the insured is legally responsible. This comes in handy with the purchase of a car or automobile, and this applies to automobile insurance. With liability coverage and within the automobile, it protects the coverage and indemnifies for the payment of damages resulting from a negligence that the other party is responsible for. What we all have as teenagers, as our parents most likely pay for omnibus clause, which basically is allowing the insurance to go family round just in case we get into an accident. It is covered by the same insurance plan as our parent. There are so many commercials out for the different types of automobile insurance you can have, but which one applies to you? Again, it depends on how much you're willing to pay and the amount of coverage that you want to get on your property. We've all seen the various commercials.
I just hit that lady!
Hey, you just hit that lady back there. You got insurance?
No, I don't have insurance.
Oh, gosh. Well, at least say the jingle.
Like a good neighbor, Miguel is there!
Well, don't worry, Christina. Your parents have good insurance. This will be covered.
Like it was stated in that commercial, it was covered by the parents because they had omnibus clause. They had the omnibus clause, which allowed for her daughter to have the coverage over the car no matter what when she got an insurance. Other parts of insurance are the collision insurance, which is what we most have, which is an automobile insurance that protects against upset and direct accidental damage due to colliding with another object. This is your run-of-the-mill, regular collision with another car that you'll be protected from. Also, there's comprehensive insurance, which is covering against all damages to the insured car except that caused by collision or upset, which is if I did something stupid to another person's car, I'm not going to be covered for my car because I caused the accident. And finally, there's no-fault insurance, which is insurance that requires that the parties to an automobile accident be covered by their own insurance company, regardless of who is at fault. The last type of insurance that most Americans have is life insurance, which is a contractual agreement under which an insurer promises to pay an agreed-upon amount of money to a named party upon the death of a particular person. Most life insurance policies typically contain exemptions that excuse the insurer from the obligation to pay the death benefit. These exemptions may include death caused by the crash of a private airplane, an act of terrorism, or during military service abroad or at home. However, the insured will undergo special underwriting. Underwriting is a process by which the insurance company examines a prospective insured with his or her express consent to determine whether to offer the coverage requested and how much the company will charge for that coverage. This is because there are many different types of life insurance and it has to be able to fit the right one so they aren't giving you the wrong type of insurance that you'll be paying in a large sum of money that will probably not cover you in case of dire emergency. In addition to these exemptions and the underwriting, a life insurance policy usually contains an incontestability clause. This clause prohibits the insurer from refusing to perform due to misrepresentation of or fraud after the policy has been in effect for a specified period of time, which is usually around 2 years for each company. Many people wonder what would happen if they didn't pay their premium for their life insurance. Well, required by state statute, a grace period is allowed, which most life insurance contracts must also provide, is a period of time with an overdue premium can be paid to keep the policy enforced. Many different terms are associated with life insurance that many people often do not understand, like HMO and PPO. An HMO, or Health Maintenance Organization, provides comprehensive, managed care to its members through fixed premiums from preventive care and screening through physicians and hospital services. This allows protection through your health insurance that will allow you to be checked out by doctors and be better maintained through your insurance and coverage. We also see PPO, or Preferred Provider Organization, which arranges for member discounts across a range of services. However, there is no primary care physician to centrally coordinate care. We even see moves by our own president that help our own individual health insurance. In March 2010, President Barack Obama signed the two bills, the Patient Protection and Affordable Health Care Act and the Health Care and Education Reconciliation Act of 2010. Together, they're more commonly known as health reform legislation, and they will be more described in our website with a more description video of both of these policies that he has passed.